What is a cathedral? How is it different than other churches? A cathedral contains the cathedra of a bishop, sometimes referred to as the chair. The cathedral serves as the mother church of a diocese. In essence, it represents Catholics in that diocese. For the Diocese of Springfield in Illinois, the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception has been that symbol.
The cathedral was completed in 1928. It began with kind of an interesting process. In 1923, Pope Pius XI moved the see of the diocese from Alton to Springfield. At that same time, he appointed Father James Griffin to be its new bishop. In 1924, Bishop Griffin was ordained a bishop, and then he moved the see from Alton to Springfield. The pro-cathedral at the time was the old St. Mary's Immaculate Conception Parish at the corner of 7th and Monroe. In 1925, Bishop Griffin announced his plans to build a new cathedral. He went over to Italy to begin the process of looking for artists and materials, things to build this. In 1926, he bought the land, which at that time was the old St. Joseph's home, and he announced the plan for the construction of the cathedral complex in early 1927 in 2 weeks' time. Almost $1 million was raised to fund this from the people of God. The estimated cost at the time was about $750,000. And then over the course of 14 months, after the cornerstone was laid in August of 1927, the entire complex was finished and dedicated in October of 1928.
Radiating with beauty, grand stained glass, reverent works of art, and bold architecture, the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception is unlike any church in the world.
Traditionally, we've referred to the cathedral architectural style as Greek Revival, which was a very common American style at the time, but it actually is what we now call the American church plan of a basilica style. So it is a rectangular building, and the facade is temple-like. So the pediment, the triangular top resting on pillars, and then a multi-tiered, in this case, three-tiered tower or steeple. Actually, if you see a picture of St. Martin in the Fields in London, you will see the similarities between the cathedral and St. Martin's.
The most impressive feature most people are in awe of when visiting here is the striking stained glass windows.
It's unique. It was made by an artist named Thomas O'Shaughnessy from Chicago. He only did four churches, and probably his most famous would be Old St. Pat's in Chicago. But the windows tell the story of the church in the world on the north side and the church in the New World on the south side. And they're made of in a mosaic style. So the glass was made actually in Kokomo, Indiana, with sand from Ottawa, Illinois. And then this was all put together by Mr. O'Shaughnessy. And what some may call, looks more like a Tiffany stained glass, but it's a mosaic style.
Located several blocks from the Illinois State House, Governor's Mansion, and the home and museum of President Abraham Lincoln, Something you also won't find anywhere else in the world is how politics and Catholicism are joined together in the stained glass.
Two of the unique features of our cathedral is that two of the windows depict two of our American presidents. George Washington is seen conversing with Bishop Carroll. Bishop Carroll was asked to travel to Canada to the French speakers of that nation to help us, or at least to stay out of the revolutionary conflict with Britain. The second window depicts President Lincoln with Archbishop Hughes of New York. Hughes was sent to France and England as well during wartime, during the Civil War, to beseech France and England to stay out of the war on the side of the South. What's unique about the Lincoln window is that by tradition, we can't prove this, but there's a middle character, and that is Lincoln's secretary. But if you look at the face of that secretary, he bears a very striking resemblance to Bishop Griffin.
What may be less known is there are three bishops buried at the cathedral.
In the sanctuary is buried in the center, Bishop Griffin, who built this as a monument to the Blessed Mother, but also as his tomb. And then he's also joined by Bishop O'Connor and Bishop McNicholas.
Another striking element of this cathedral is the ceiling, with its detailed artwork and unique look.
The layout of the church itself, there's been dispute about that, but with the columns, the pillars, it's more reminiscent of St. Mary Major in Rome, Maria Maggiore, and in fact, the ceiling in the restoration in 2009 was redone to replicate the ceiling of St. Mary Major.
Dedicated to our Mother. The Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception in Springfield, a church filled with one-of-a-kind history and beauty, and the presence of Jesus Christ.
As cathedral, we're the mother church of the diocese. We're not set above, set below, but we have that unique position of being the bishop's church, and we're very happy to welcome visitors from throughout the diocese and throughout the country and the world as they come to see the beauty of this place, all of which our hope is points them to the transcendence and the glory of God.